Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about one of the wireless technology that is nothing but Bluetooth, then its advantage, disadvantage, usage. Along with that, we are also going to discuss a concept about Piconet and Scatternet. So let's begin with the topic. Bluetooth is basically a wireless technology which is evolved or developed in order to remove the need of cable connection to a portable devices, which allows user mobility. So without having a wired connection to a portable device, and in order to provide a communication between the two devices, it's possible to perform by using a Bluetooth. So let's start with the discussion on Bluetooth. Bluetooth is a wireless technology which is basically used for a short-range communication between the devices and intended to replace the cable connecting portable unit and maintaining high levels of security. Bluetooth technology is based on ad hoc technology, which is also called as ad hoc Piconet. When two or more than two devices connect to each other by using a Bluetooth technology, then it forms a Piconet, that is a very small network, which is a local area network with a very limited coverage. As the range of Bluetooth is not too much high, it is very short, that is 8 to 10 meters only. Therefore, if the network is get formed between two or more than two devices by using Bluetooth, then it is called as Bluetooth network, or we can say it is a Piconet, or simply it is called as ad hoc network or ad hoc Piconet. Each device can simultaneously communicate with up to 7 devices within single Piconet. So we can connect 7 devices by using a Bluetooth technology. An ad hoc network including one device which acts as a master, another 7 devices are acts as a slave for lifetime of the Piconet. So the time duration during which the Piconet exists, in which one device is acts as a master and another remaining devices acts as a slave. Slaves have to be synchronized with the system clock of the master so that the proper communication takes place. Whatever the data is get transmitted by master with the speed, the slaves get receive the data at the same speed. And that is possible because of the synchronization of the system clock between master and slave, and follow hopping pattern determined by the master. Now, the main attractive characteristics of the Bluetooth is to allow wide range of Bluetooth-enabled device to connect and communicate with each other almost everywhere in the world. There is no restriction on the Bluetooth technology that how many number of devices can be connected or how the devices get connected. So this is considered as one of the most attractive features of the Bluetooth, that we can connect it to any phone with on anywhere in the world. Another key feature of the Bluetooth is its ability of the device to communicate without need of line of sight positioning of the connecting device. There is no need to have a line of sight between the devices. The device can be anywhere and it can perform the communication between the two devices without actually having the line of sight. So line of sight restriction is not present in case of Bluetooth technology. And because of that, it is widely used for connecting the variety of personally carried devices which supports data and voice applications. Now let's move on to the frequency which are used for the Bluetooth. There are different frequency ranges provided for industrial, scientific and medical reason. This band specified of the energy is nothing but 2.4 gigahertz ISM band, and which having a frequency hopping of 71 megahertz channel, and the rate of transmission is 1600 hops per second for reducing the interference between the network. The standard specified three classes of the device with different transmission power and corresponds to the different coverage. And the three classes of the devices are 1 to 100 meter and having the maximum data transfer rate of 3 Mbps. So depending upon the range and transmitted power, the device in the Bluetooth is get classified having a range of 1 to 100 meter. Then next is nothing but Bluetooth low energy. It is, we can say that it is a derived version of the Bluetooth. As its name indicates, it uses low energy, or it requires low energy for its operation, so that it can be used in the network like wireless body area network, where one of the important requirement is nothing but low power consumption. So that requirement is get fulfilled by using a derived version of Bluetooth, which is nothing but Bluetooth low energy. So now let's have a discussion on Bluetooth low energy, what it is and how it exactly performs the function. It is derived option of the Bluetooth standard, and that is nothing but Bluetooth low energy, which is also called as BLE7, which was introduced as more suitable choice of wireless body area network, where less power consumption is possible using low duty cycle operation. Because in case of wireless body area network, as the sensors are installed inside the human body and or around the human body. Therefore, it is very much important that the sensor should consume less power and that power and to have a communication with the nearby device. So such type of operation is available with the help of Bluetooth low energy. So this is basically is used for V-band applications. And for generating low power, it produces or it uses low duty cycle operation. Bluetooth LE, that means Bluetooth low energy, was designed to wirelessly connect small devices to a mobile terminals. Those devices are often too tiny to bear the power consumption as well as cost associated with a standard Bluetooth radio, but ideal choice for the health monitoring application. As we know, one of the popular application of wireless body area network is nothing but healthcare application, in which the various sensors are used to monitor the vital parameters of the human body, which includes heart rate, blood pressure, then temperature and various other parameters. So the sensors which are inside or the sensors which are placed inside the human body are supposed to be very tiny sensors so that they will not have any constraint on the mobility of the user or mobility of the patient. Therefore, in that case, in order to achieve the communication between that sensor and the controlling device, a wireless technology is required to be used for the communication purpose. And that requirement is fulfilled by Bluetooth low energy version of the Bluetooth, which uses low power for its operation. Bluetooth low energy technology is expected to provide data rate up to 1 Mbps. So maximum data rate of 1 Mbps can be provided by using Bluetooth low energy devices. Using few channels for pairing devices, synchronization can be done in few milliseconds compared to Bluetooth in second. In case of Bluetooth, the synchronization between the master and slave, or we can say the synchronization between the two different devices, requires a time period of few seconds. But in case of Bluetooth low energy, that synchronization can take place in very few seconds rather than taking time in seconds. This latency critical benefit, this benefits latency critical band application like alarm generation and emergency response and enhances power saving. So because of this very less amount of time required for the pairing that is in millisecond, it is possible to use the Bluetooth low energy devices in the wireless body area network application, which includes emergency response or it includes generation generating the alarm. So in case of emergency, this type of devices can be used, and as it uses low power, therefore it also leads to a consumption or saving of power. Its nominal data rate, low latency and low energy consumption makes BLE suitable for communication between the wearable sensor node and access point. So as we have discussed now only that it is mostly used in the wireless body area network application where low power consumption is required, low latency is required, and as well as a nominal data rate is required. So all these requirements are get fulfilled by using a wireless Bluetooth low area network or wireless Bluetooth low area technology. So they are used between the wearable sensors which are present inside the human body or around the human body and between the access point. The adaptive frequency hop spread spectrum allows Bluetooth low energy to coexist with the Wi-Fi. Interference with other devices might be issue as the technology operates on the band of 2.4 GHz ISM band. So other devices or other technology operates on the same band can have a interference on the Bluetooth low energy devices. Bluetooth is more advantageous in supporting applications where different data rates, network coverage and power requirements are needed. So basically we can say it is the most convenient short range communication in which the low data rates are required for the applications and two peer-to-peer devices are connected in an ad hoc configuration. That means a temporary connection is get established between the devices and between we can say the connection between two person servers of two wireless body area network or between wireless body area network and personal computer. That means the communication is temporary and it is a very short range communication. Therefore, we can say it is convenient for the devices which are required more mobility as compared to the wired connection. Now let's move on to the history of Bluetooth, how it is get derived and when it is invented. So in 1994, Ericsson Bluetooth project defines a standard for personal area network to enable the communication between the mobile phone using low energy and low cost radio interference or by using low energy low cost radio interface. But before that, in 1988, the companies like IBM, Intel, Nokia, and Toshiba joined Ericsson to form a Bluetooth special interest group whose main aim was to develop a standard for communication standard for personal area network so that the two devices can communicate with each other without having the actual wired connection. They can communicate with each other by using the wireless communication. Next, after that, after forming a group for defining a standard for personal area network, the IEEE approved Bluetooth based standard, which is named as IEEE 802.15.1 for wireless personal area network. And IEEE standard covers MAC and physical layer applications. So the standards is get finalized by using IEEE, and they named it as IEEE 802.15.1 standard. Bluetooth specification details the entire protocol stack. Bluetooth employs radio frequency for the communication. It makes the use of frequency modulation to generate radio waves in ISM band. So basically the Bluetooth uses radio frequency for the communication between the two or more than two devices. Then it uses a frequency modulation technique for transmission of the data as it is get less affected by noise. And it generates a radio waves in IMS band, which is having a frequency range of 2.4 gigahertz. Now let's move on to the usage of Bluetooth. That means the application where we can use Bluetooth technology for the communication purpose. It offers uniform structure for a wide range of devices to connect and communicate with each other. We can connect up to 7 devices if it is master-slave type of Bluetooth network, or we can connect n number of devices to form a Piconet. Bluetooth technology has achieved a global acceptance, such as any Bluetooth-enabled device almost everywhere in the world can be connected with another Bluetooth-enabled device. As we just discussed, that is low power Bluetooth or Bluetooth low energy uses less amount of power, and therefore it can be used in the healthcare application. So low power consumption of Bluetooth technology and offered a range up to 10 meters has become the way of several usage model. Then it offers the interactive conference by establishing an ad hoc network on the laptops. Bluetooth usage model includes cordless computer, intercom, cordless phone and mobile phone. So the component of the devices with which you can form ad hoc network or Piconet includes the cordless phone, it includes mobile phone, then it includes the computers, intercom, or any other device which is Bluetooth enabled can be used to form a Piconet by connecting with other Bluetooth enabled device. And because of this connectivity advantage, the Bluetooth standard is get globally accepted as it provides a wireless connectivity between two devices. Now, after having discussion on the concept of Bluetooth, next is nothing but the concept of Piconet and Scatternet comes into the picture. So let's move on to Piconet and Scatternet. Bluetooth-enabled electronic device connect and communicated wirelessly through a short range, which is called as Piconet. So whenever two or more than two Bluetooth-enabled device forms a network with each other within a short range of distance, then we can say it forms a Piconet. Bluetooth device exists in a small ad hoc configuration with ability to act either as a master or as a slave. That the specification allows mechanism for master and slave switch the roles. Now, when the Bluetooth network is formed, one device acts as a master, another device is connected to it acts as a slave. Depending upon in which application we are using the technology, based on that, the role of master and slave can get switched with each other. Point-to-point configuration with one master and one slave is the simplest configuration. For example, if the two mobiles connected to each other by using a Bluetooth technology, then the transmitter, that means the device which sends the data, acts as a master, and the receiver which receives the data from transmitter acts as a slave. So this is called as one-to-one configuration, in which one master is present, another slave is present. The transmitter usually acts as a master and the receiver is usually acts as a slave. But in order to have the communication between master and slave, it is very much important that there must be a synchronization, or we can say there must be a synchronization in the system clock of master and the system clock of slave, so that the proper data can be get received between the network. When more than two Bluetooth devices communicate with each other, then it is called as Piconet. A Piconet can contain up to 7 slave clustered around a single master. So in total, we can connect 8 devices by using Bluetooth technology. Out of that 8 device, one device acts as a master, and to that one master, we can connect up to 7 different types of slave devices. The device that initializes the establishment of the Piconet becomes a master. As I said, if we consider the example of one-to-one communication, then the transmitter is called as master. So similarly, in case of seven slaves and one master, the device which initiates the communication, that means the device which performs the transmission, is called as master, and the device which receives the data are called as slaves. The master is responsible for transmission control by dividing the network into a series of time slots amongst the network members, such as time division multiplexing technique is used. So for transfer of data, the master basically divides the time duration or the time slot to which data can be transmitted to a particular device, and slave receives the data based on that time duration or time slot technique, which is called as time division multiplexing. So here we can say the figure of Piconet and Scatternet. Here M, S, S, S and B. This single network is called as Piconet, and this single network is called as Piconet 2. So when two Piconet interact with each other, then it forms a Scatternet. So if we can say when two or more than two Piconet connect with each other, then it forms a Scatternet. So here we can say the Piconet 1, for example, this is a Piconet 1. Then M indicates master and remaining devices are acts as a slave. Here also I mean Piconet 2, which is indicated by P2. M acts as a master and remaining devices acts as a slave. So this is about the Piconet and Scatternet. Now let's move on to the various features provided by the Piconet. Within Piconet, the timing of various devices and the frequency hopping sequence of the individual device is determined by the clock and unique 48-bit address of the master. So as the master initiates the communication, therefore the time duration to which each slave can be served is decided by the master only, and it is based on the system clock and 48-bit address of the master. Now each device can communicate simultaneously with seven devices connected to single Piconet. So in single Piconet, one master and a maximum number of seven devices can be connected to one master. Each device can communicate with the several Piconets simultaneously. It is not necessary that the device required to communicate with the master of the single Piconet. As in figure we saw, device B can communicate with Piconet 1 master as well as Piconet 2 master. So depending upon the device, from where it requires a service and what service it requires, it can communicate with other Piconets also. Piconets are established dynamically and automatically as a Bluetooth enabled device enters and leaves the Piconet. The termination and starting of Piconet is dynamic. Whenever the device which is Bluetooth enabled enters into the network range of the Piconet, then it forms that network with the master. As it leaves the network or the device, connection is get terminated for that particular device. There is no direct connection between slave, and all the connections are essentially master to slave or slave to master. Slaves are allowed to transmit once these has been polled by master. So whenever the master wants a service from slave, that only the slaves are allowed to transmit to the master. Transmission starts in the slave to master time slot in immediately following the polling packets from the master. So whenever the slave receives a polling packet from the master, then for that duration only the transmission from slave to master is get started. A device can be a member of two or more than two Piconet. Jumping from one Piconet to another Piconet by adjusting the transmission regime timing and frequency hopping sequence dedicated by the master device on the second Piconet. So it is not necessary that the device required to communicate with one Piconet only. If it requires service from other Piconet or if it requires service from other master, then also it is possible for the device to communicate with that particular Piconet or that particular master. It can be a slave in one Piconet and master in another. However, it cannot be master in more than one Piconet. So one device can be work as a master for one Piconet also, but one device can act as a slave for two or more than two Piconet. Device resident in adjacent Piconet provide a bridge to support inter-Piconet connection, allowing assembly of the link Piconet to form a physical communication infrastructure called as Scatternet. Or in simple language, when two or more than two Piconet get connected with each other or when communicate with each other, then it forms a network which is called as Scatternet. The advantage of Piconet Scatternet technique is that it allows many devices to share the same physical area and to make the efficient use of bandwidth. As the devices are present within a small range or within a short range, it is possible to share or it is possible to use the same physical area by your different device. At the same time, the utilization of the channel bandwidth is also takes place. So because of that, the channel bandwidth is get saved and we can transmit more and more amount of data on the same channel bandwidth. The next is nothing but the spectrum, and this spectrum is related to the Bluetooth technology. The Bluetooth technology operates in unlicensed industrial specific medical ISM band, which is having a range from 2.4 GHz to 2.485 GHz, using a spread spectrum hopping full duplex signal having a rate or the nominal rate of 1600 hops per second. The 2.4 GHz ISM band is available and it is unlicensed in most of the countries. And this band is specifically used for industrial application, it is used for the medical application, it is used for the scientific applications. Then the next is nothing but range of Bluetooth. The operating range of Bluetooth is depending upon the class of the device. For class 3 radio having a range up to 1 to 3 meter, the class 2 devices having a range up to 10 meters or 30 feet, and it is basically found in the mobile device. The range is for the mobile device, that means the mobile device comes under the class 2 devices. And class 1 radios are used in the industrial application, which provides a range of 100 meter, or we can say it provides a range up to 300 feet. So depending upon the class of device, the range of the Bluetooth is get changed. Then next is nothing but the data rate. The Bluetooth supports a data rate up to 1 Mbps for version 1.2 and 3 Mbps for version 2.0. And that 2.0 version data rate is combined with the error data rate. So this is what about the data rate provided by Bluetooth technology. Next is nothing but the very important point that is related to the security, that means Bluetooth security. Because whenever the communication takes place, there may be a chances that the data is get corrupted or it get interfered with the other type of message. So in order to avoid that and in order to transmit and receive the error-free data, the security of the Bluetooth comes into the picture. So Bluetooth has a powerful security features with a secure and fast encryption routine, which is also called as SAFER+, and which uses up to 128 bit of keys. So as the number of bits of keys get increased, the level of security is also get increases. At the link level, it is possible to authenticate a device. So at the connection level only, it is possible for the slave to, or it is possible for the master to perform the authentication. It will be convenient and it will be easy for the device or master or slave also to understand whether the connection is legal connection or not. This verifies that the pair of device shared the secret key reserved for a Bluetooth pass key, and also known as personal identification number, that is P. Whenever the two Bluetooth devices get connected to each other, every time they require to ask the permission to other device whether they want to perform the Bluetooth connectivity or not. And for that purpose, they require certain number or certain key, which is also called as encryption key, or is also called as personal identification number. So when pin of both transmitter and receiver, or else we can say when pin of both master and slave get matched with each other, then only the Bluetooth connectivity takes place. And this is how security in the Bluetooth is get achieved, so that less amount of error get present in the transmitted and received signal. The Bluetooth pass key, that means the personal identification number PIN, is entered either in a user interface or for a device such as handset which do not have user interface. A manufacturer can build in it. In case of handset, it is not possible to provide the user interface, so in that case the PIN is get installed inside the headset only, or inside the device only, which is performed by manufacturer. After authentication, the device can create a shared link key which can be used to encrypt the traffic on the link. So based on the PIN number, if they matches with each other, the communication or the wireless network is get formed between the device and the other device, or between the device or other hardware. So when the authentication takes place and the link layer is get formed, or the link layer communication is get formed between the two devices, then it is called as pairing. Exchange of high level security information, and it is called as bonding. So at low level operation, it is called as pairing. And when we move to industrial application or high level application, then it is called as bonding between the two devices, or at low level it is called as peering between the two devices. The authentication may be repeated after peering, in which case the link key is used as a shared secret key. So in after authentication or after peering also, it is possible to perform the authentication by using a secret key. The three modes of security can be implemented, and the modes are mode 1, which is not secured. The second is mode 2, which has a security imposed on the request of the application and service. And mode 3, it has a security imposed when new connection is get established. So depending upon the mode of operation, or we can say depending upon the mode whether the device required to perform the secure connection or not, the different types of securities are used. The three different modes are mode 1, which is usually not secure mode. Mode 2, which causes or which provides the request for application and service. So whenever the application or service generate a request for the security, then only it will operate in mode 2. And mode 3 has a security imposed when the new connection is get established. So whenever the new device or new connection comes into the Piconet, the device requests for a Bluetooth security. So this is what about the Bluetooth, which having a various key features that we can say it is a robustness, then low complexity, then main advantage is nothing but the low power and low cost. The technology offers wireless access across the wireless area network, or we can say across the wireless LAN network, and therefore it is find most of the application in wireless body area network because of its advantage of low power consumption and low cost. The immediate need of Bluetooth comes from the desire to connect the peripheral and the devices without the cable. A Bluetooth could also be used in the home and networking application. So basically the Bluetooth is used in the application where required to form a small network without actually connecting the wires and having a wireless communication. With increase in the number of homes having multiple PCs, the need of network that are simple and install and maintain is growing. There is also a commercial need to provide the information push capability, which is important and handheld for other such mobile devices, and this has been partially incorporated in case of Bluetooth. The main strength of Bluetooth is its ability to simultaneously handle both data and voice transmission. We can transmit data as well as voice by using the same Bluetooth network, and therefore such innovative solution as a mobile hands-free handset for a voice call, print to fax capability, and automatically synchronization PDA laptop and cell phone address books application. So because of the simultaneous transmission of data and voice, the Bluetooth find application in many fields. For example, a Bluetooth handset which allows the transmission of voice as well as transmission of audio, then laptops and cell phone address book application in which we can use Bluetooth technology for the connection purpose. So this suggests that the Bluetooth is extremely useful and will have a significant effect on the way of information is accessed and used. So by using the Bluetooth technology, it is possible to transmit and receive the data, which includes voice, audio, video, and many other form of signals. And because of that, it is possible to used in variety of applications. Though it provides a very short range communication, but the requirement for the communications are also like low cost, then it requires low power consumption, because of which we can say that the Bluetooth is considered as the emerging and the most attractive technology for wireless network, which is used for transmission of data, which can be of any form. The frequency spectrum or the frequency band used for the Bluetooth is unlicensed frequency band, and that is used for the industrial, scientific and medical purpose, having a frequency range of 2.4 to 2.485 gigahertz, and it's having a nominal rate of 1600 hops per second. The maximum data rate that can be provided by Bluetooth is 1 Mbps. Depending upon the mode, the Bluetooth provides a different security. The three modes are mode 1, mode 2 and mode 3. Out of that, mode 1 is not secure mode. Mode 2 provides moderate security, whereas mode 3 provides high security. Whenever the connection between the two or more than two device or the two or more than two Bluetooth enabled device takes place, then it is called as Piconet, in which one device acts as a master, another device acts as a slave. Maximum 7 slaves can be connected to one master. So one Piconet consists of one master device and other 7 slave devices. When two or more than two Piconet connected with each other, then it forms a scatternet, or n number of scatternet that can be formed. A device can perform a communication with its own Piconet as well as with the other Piconet also, but it acts as a master only for one Piconet. The device can act as a slave for its one or more than one Piconet. So because of the many attractive features, the Bluetooth is finding as an emerging and developing technology in case of many applications, which includes the wireless body area network application, in which the data transmission requirement is nothing but low power consumption, and for that Bluetooth low energy, that is the derived version of Bluetooth, comes into picture. So this is what about the Bluetooth and concept of Piconet Scatternet. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.